Hey guys, had another pretty day here up on the mountain, and just wanted to show you how pretty the sky looks, actually. Pink clouds. But headed on down to the shop to show you a very, 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 very sharp knife. Hey, this is a Chuck Richards Mini Skinner. A while back I got this from Chuck. I asked him to send it to me raw, unsharpened, unfinished, just right out of heat treat, because I loved the purple on the D2. I just love that. It just looks awesome to me. I really like it. And then once I got the knife, you know, I started realizing, wow, man, maybe I just don't have the tools or the skills to get an edge on this thing. You know, it's so easy to mess it up. It's so easy to get a wavy blade that isn't perfectly straight, or has something wrong with the profile or something. So anyway, trepidation set in. So this knife has been sitting here for the best part of a year. Now I finally got around to it, and what I ended up doing was block sanding. Doing a lot of block sanding. It was super tedious. There's still a lot of scratches left in it. All the scratches in it now are about 320. So I would have to move on up to 600 to get those out. It's been run on my buffing wheel. Because what I've done is I did not want a secondary edge on it. I wanted a true convex. This is very shallow. Okay, it's not flat. It's almost flat, slightly convex. And I took it off the buffing wheel, and just out of curiosity, I was like, I wonder if this thing's sharp. And I found, wow, it's really kind of crazy sharp, considering that it's only been, you know, 320 and a buffing wheel. And we're talking about the kind of sharp where you don't even hardly push in the, it's just taking hair off, huge patches of hair. It's sharp all of it, all the different parts of it. So that's pretty wild. So yeah, that's a lot of hair just shaved off. Anyway, and of course it'll cut paper, whatever else you want it to cut. But I've got a piece of paper here. We can just have a look at how it cuts. You know, I'm just real happy with the cutting performance of it. It doesn't require a lot of pressure to get going on it. Get little itty bitty curly cues, of course. Cut curves. Yeah. Get up here. Cut little itsy bitsies right off with the tip. But just the very tip of it up in there. So as a skinner, this would be a good little skinning knife for sure, I think. Because it doesn't take a lot of effort to cut. And it's not really, you know, a piercing knife, but it does have, you know, decent piercing. Not a lot of pressure. It just goes right through. Once that edge touches it, you're pretty much going to go through it. So, and this is not even really sharp. This is just excellent steel. It's a D2. It's a dream to work with. It's just beautiful stuff. I have a D2 sword that I love. This is awesome. So I just wanted to show it to you guys. Finally got around to sharpening the Chuck Richards Mini Skinner. Next step is to come up with how I want to deal with it. I don't know if I want to put handles on it to follow the contour, or if I want to make an all wood type of deal where the sheath and the handle are all made out of the same piece of wood with the grain following through. Really don't know. Well, thanks for watching, guys. And check out Chuck Richards' knife making. He's very talented.